Hello, everybody. Welcome in our first painting masterclass. We are streaming this through StreamYard, and I read that in a Facebook you're going to have some delay. But for now, we're just going to wait for a few people to join us because I know Facebook not going to give you the notification straight away that we are live. Here with me is Nicole Caring. She's going to show you the doors, what I was talking about, and she will paint along with the doors. So, hi, Nicole. How are you?
Hi, I'm good. How are you?
Oh, I'm fine. Just a bit, butterflies in my belly, but I'm fine.
Brilliant.
Somebody's watching us right now already, so that's cool. Just want to wait a few seconds to make sure everybody who told us that they're gonna come, they will come.
Brilliant.
And I will do a little bit of a training about double dip painting, triple dip painting, and one stroke painting. And I hope you will enjoy this all. So, whoever is here with us, if you don't have your bucket of water, well, let's just go through what you need. So you need some water. I'm having my bucket. That's my favorite thing now. because in this bucket, actually, if I move a little bit, this side is a dirty water. It have ridges inside, so I can clean my brush easily. And this side is for clean water. So if you're using lots of water, like if you're a painter, you will love this paint bucket. Also, for practice, you will need a paper. I'm using a high quality paper, which is made for painting purposes, but it doesn't really matter. It's just the paper for the few first patterns that you can practice on. Two people watching now. Say hello if you're watching, so we know who's watching here, so I can interact with you all. Then my favorite thing is to have a wipe in hand in case you got dirty. You might want have to have some. You will need your paint brushes. Now I have a lot with me, but you obviously only need one round brush and one flat brush. Where is my camera? Yeah. I have multiple one because maybe you need me to show in a bigger one, maybe you need me to show in a smaller one, or different kind of brushes, so I have them with me. I will paint along on the camper van today. So I'm so excited to see how will it look on a wood because I haven't painted in wood before. And I like to have a cloth with me. Now, if you have wipes with you, you don't really need a cloth, but I like to use this cloth because it's just handy, it's easier to have it with me. And you will need a paint palette, which is my tray. I will use my tray as a paint palette. And your paint, of course. So I'm having my paints here. So if you don't have these all things, I'm going to count till 20, and then you can run and grab the stuff what you not have with you. So I'm just going to count now. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, and 20. So let's get started with the painting. What I'm going to do now, I'll just grab my paint palette. And I'm going to shift my camera so you can see my hand. What am I doing? Hopefully. It might take a little while. Should have done that by the time I was counting. Okay, a bit further. Right. Can you see my paper well
Yeah,
now? Okay.
can see it fine.
Right. Usually, to do the double dip patterns, we use white paint and another any color because that gives the nicest pattern because the white gives a great contrast. I'm just going to put a bit of white on my palette, and you can just go ahead and do that. Choose your first color and put it on the palette. Because nobody commenting, I don't know what age range we are, so I'm going to break it down for a little bit, maybe childish one, maybe. So that way the children can follow along, and well, adults can follow the children illustration as well, so never mind that. I'm going to use my camera is mirroring me, so a purple as well. And the other thing you're going to need now is the round brush. Round brush you will need, a bigger round brush. And I just created some rhyme with these things. So if there are children, let's pretend we are wizards in fairyland or magic land, and our paint brushes are our wands. And I'm just need you to see. So when other way when we're going to paint, I want you to follow me along. So the rhyme will come the way you have the first color ready, and you rub your paint inside, and I say rub it in one color, then clean it off the end, dip it in the other one, then you are prepared. Can you do it with me? Let's do it together. Rub it in one color, wipe it off the end, dip it in the other. Now we are prepared. Now let's see how will it look with the paint. Right, so of course we need some water, but I forgot to tell you. So what I'm going to do is I dip my other side. I dip my brush in the water and I press out the excess on the side. Now I rub it in one color, the way that is fully loaded. Right, where is the camera? It's really hard to tell where is the camera. Can you see it's fully loaded now? Then you just wipe off the very tip of it. You see the tip is not have the white now. Hopefully you can see, I'm not sure.
Yeah.
And then we dip it in the other one. And now we are prepared.
That's cool.
So once you have your brush loaded, don't know where I put this cable. What you want to do is you have to hold your brush in 90 degree with the surface what you want to paint. And then you just lay it down, and you created a petal. I don't know how much you can see. I might turn around my paper. Can you see the petal there?
Yeah.
So this is one petal we made. And then you just make another one right next to it. You see? You have two petals now. And that's how you do double dip flowers. Usually we do three of them. Now you can see my paint is run out. My paint have run out. And my daughter just knocking on the door. I hope my husband have a key with him, because I just told them to. Actually, I asked my husband to interact my with my child children while I'm doing this. So it's quite bit tricky. So when you run out of the paint like this, you have to load it again. And with double dip, what I don't like actually, that you need to start the whole process again. So you have to wash off everything from your paint, from your brush, and start the process again. So rub it in one color. Wipe it off the end. Dip it in the next one. Then you are prepared. And let's see how will it look on the camper van. Now I'm going to paint the top of my camper van. One, two, three, four, five.
Oh,
As
wow.
this is done, but I figured out that my paint is only giving me about three petals. So every three, four petal, I have to load it again. Some of the paint will do more coverage, but this is an easy way to get yourself a two-colored flower. Now, what you can do, you can make a butterfly the same way. Just load your brush again. Quick as I can go. And a different kind of paint will give you different kind of result. And for example, with the face paint, it will be way easier to do this. But to do a butterfly, you just make something like this. This is one wing, and this is the other wing, and then you do the same on the other side. I'm just loading my brush again and wiping the edge. I have my purple on, and then I do the other side. One, two, three. One, two. And now you just choose one color. I'll just put another color in here. Let's see. Let's go by wild and do with blue. There. Oh, somebody said, "Hey, wow, that's amazing." Unfortunately, I can't see who is it because it's just say Facebook user.
Stephanie, it is.
Stephanie, all right.
Well,
I
you could
think there was something you
me.
have to agree with, and then it will give me the name. Otherwise, it won't give me the name. So I just loaded my brush. Where is my camera? It's so funny. I just loaded my brush with blue, and now I'm just going to make a butterfly. I might have put these things a little bit too far away. But you can see I have my butterfly here. Let's have some antennae.
This is something new. I never knew this is how you do things like that, which is amazing. So.
I never knew before I started to paint. Now, if you have an issue like me that you had your petal too far away, don't worry. Once the petal dried, you can paint over it. Mine is not dried completely, but I'm going to make some new petals the way that it will cover my butterfly better. I'm just dipping it off. And I can put them here, 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 make it a
It is
bit bigger.
incredible,
Sorry?
I'm guessing this Stephanie again said it's incredible.
Yeah, let's bring it on a. Yes, I think, yeah, Stephanie said she's going to watch us, so let us know who you are. Mysterious Facebook user. But yeah, say that's good. I don't know that how you do that. Yeah, and she's also saying it's incredible. Thank you. So I'm going to fix up the other side of my butterfly as well. And then you have it. You have your double dip butterfly there. It's a bit
Amazing.
chunky, but you get the idea, really. So to make triple dip is exactly the same thing. The difference is you're going to do the rubbing off and dipping again twice. So what we're going to do is we're loading it up with the white. And you know you loaded your brush well if your color is right to the next to this metal part, so close to it. Then I wipe off a little bit bigger chunk than before. Like, can you see? A bit bigger. Now I'm going to put that end into my purple. Just the end. There. You see, it's a little bit more purple on there. Now I'm going to rub it off again. Yeah, she says, it's me, it's Stephanie. Now I rubbed off the end again, and I'm going to dip it in my blue, just the edge of it. Can see now I have three colors on my brush. And then I can do the exact same thing. I'm just holding my brush 90 degree from the surface I'm painting, and I make a blob down and make another next to it. You can see it gives me a three color
That's
petal.
amazing.
I really love this technique, but what I don't like is that it's run out quickly and then you have to keep washing, washing, and then dipping again. So that's not my favorite technique. Now, just to have a little break. I don't know if everybody having a good value of this now. Let's turn this around. Are you having good value so far? Let's hide this away. So I hope you do. So I just prepared something and I hope you don't mind to share it with you. I actually launching my VIP group in the future. So it will be a paid group where you can pay a membership which is give you access for trainings, for art trainings, but it's not just painting. It will be like beading, it will be crochet, knitting, sculpting, mixed media, stuff like that. So anything in your mind, you can ask me in that group, and we will have twice a month mastermind calls in a Zoom, which is again, you can let me know what's your trouble, what's troubling you, what problems you are having regarding to art, craft, and design. If you have any homework you can't finish in this area, and there will be lots of trainings every week, minimum one video and some extra files as well. So if you're interested in this VIP group, then I will after the video I will put the link below this training what we just have now, and you can all have a look and see and join me in there if you'd like to. So I thought we can have some break. Nicole, can you show us the teddy bears what we have
Yeah.
in our Kids Be Happy, or next to Kids Be Happy,
So,
product we can do.
yeah, so the bears are, so this is a stuffed one that I've done. This is a 16-inch bear, this one is. It's not a bear, the dog, but yeah, it's our 16-inch. They all come with a little bag attached to him. That's where you open the zip. I'll have a fight with it now because I've already closed it, so bear with me. Thing is, when you close it, you can't open it again, so it's child-proof, but it's also adult-proof because you are meant to open it again if possible.
That's so
But
cool because kids always want to open everything and get the stuff out, and if it's childproof, that's so
yeah.
cool.
So as soon as you close it, oh, there you go, I've managed to open it. Kids can't open it. As you just saw, I had difficulties. So this is where you put the stuffing in that way. So this is our bulldog. Oh. And then we've also got a husky. This is another 16-inch one. How cute is he? The colours. Then we have a multicoloured one.
Oh, I loved rainbow. Lots of
So,
kids love rainbow too.
yeah. So these are all our
Wow,
16-inch ones. We've got penguin.
how cute is that?
It's
I haven't seen those penguins. Oh.
and we have a brown bear. And all the teddies. Then we got a dino.
Yeah, Stephanie said they are so cute. They look so soft. Yeah, I know we have lighting unicorns as well, and oh, they're so nice. And that dinosaur you just showed, that's one of my favorite dinosaurs.
Yeah, we got an owl and we then got a sh lamb sheep type
Oh,
one.
cute.
They all come, the 16-inch ones come with an under 100 gram of stuffing and they come with a bag to put them in. They then also come with a birth certificate so they can write, and they come with a wishing star or wishing heart with little words on. Got best friend, got love, got courage, kindness, quite a
Fun.
few. So, and then
What
I've made.
do you do with the wishing stars? Because I always thought of that. What can I do with the wishing star? What do people do with the wishing star?
The way that I do the wishing stars is I tell a child to make a wish and to pop it in. With the wishing heart and stars, The reason why they've got names on is due to a bullying campaign that they'd done. So we did a lot of workshops with them when before COVID, that you could put them in and make a wish in that way. And then I got one six, not six, 8-inch teddy. I've got all the teddies from the back of me. It's a little elephant.
That's so cute. I
How
love
cute.
them.
His eyes are, I don't know if you can see his eyes. His eyes are proper glittery.
Wow.
They are so cute.
So,
Ooh, these
anyone
little.
who's watching this video now, make sure to find a person who shows you the video. Either if you find us on Nicole's page, then go to talk with Nicole if you'd like these bears or any, the camper vans or the door what she's painting or anything. If you come from Nicole's page, please talk with Nicole about them. And if you came from my page, then I'm your person to talk with about it. But the VIP group is just working through me. So if you'd like to have access for the VIP group, then you have to find me on the Crafty Corner team side page or Crafty Corner Kids Be Happy independent consultant page, sorry. So let's get back to the painting, and I'm going to show you the one stroke painting now. I'm going to turn my camera back if I can. La, bit tricky. I'm new with this thing, this ring camera and everything. So what you're going to need now is a flat brush, and I'm going to leave my paint like this. But when you lay down your paint, or you can use your brush anyway. So you just dip your brush in the water, press out the excess water like we did before. And which two colors should I use? The white and the pink, white and the blue, or the pink and the blue?
Pink and the blue, I think.
Okay. Not sure what will that create. So what you want to do is take one color on one side and take the other color on the other side, like this. And now you just go place your brush down and left and right and left and right, making sure that you're staying in the same place, not moving up or down, staying on the same place. If you need more paint, because you need to fill this brush up until the metal things again. If you need more paint, you just grab again. Make sure you grab the same side. So where you had the pink, you grab the pink on that side. Where you had the blue, you rub the pink, the blue from that side. And be very careful to place your brush back exactly where it was and go back and forth until you loaded your brush up. In the beginning, it would take a little time. You can either do like one, two, three, and one, two, three. You can see I loaded my brush now. And then what we're going to do, I hope you see well. Again, you hold your brush 90 degrees and you're going to put it down, but don't press and wiggle it a little bit. And that is one petal. I'm used to paint on my hand with a face paint, so it's easier, it's more convenient to use it that way, but you can see that one petal. Now, if you load well, you can create more than one petal, but I usually need to load my brush all the time. But the good thing with this, you don't need to wash your brush all the time. You just go back in your paint, load it again, and then you can paint again. Then you just put the next petal, wiggle it a little bit. And there you have your next petal. It's in the beginning, it's a bit tricky to get the right angle of the brush and the right pressure of the brush. But once you master it, you can actually do so many different patterns with it, so many different flowers with it. You might need to add more water regarding to which surface you're painting. My paper looks like eating up the paint, so I needed to put some more water. And now I'm loading it again. And when you put more water, you just need to dip the very, very tip of your brush in the water, not too much. Then you can make another one. Usually we make 5 petals with the flower, but am I gonna need 6 in here now? And load one more. And then I would really love to see what you're making at home, so please feel free to show me in the comments your progress in this lesson. You see? Now what we can do, if this is dried, we can make some inside petals, and then it become some kind of like a rose. But yes,
that's awesome. Yeah, I love all the different technique you're showing us. They're fab.
Yeah, Steph say, wow, such good techniques. Thanks, Steph. So what I'm going to do now, I'm going to try to find an empty space like this, and I'm going to show you a quick butterfly in here. Because why not? I love butterflies. And kids usually love butterflies. So again, load the brush a bit. Little bit of water. And then how do I do so? This way, you see. I'm going to make a line and wiggle this way, and then wiggle a little bit more, a bit down. This is the top wing, and then we do a little one in here. That's the bottom wing. Now I just put this brush down until my flower is drying, and I'm going to use a small brush. If I find us, I don't find it, but I can use the bigger one now. Never mind. I'm going to make the body of this butterfly with white. This way. What you want to do is you just put the head here, and it's not really showing up on my thingy on white, so I'm going to use my purple instead. I have the head here, and I make the body here. And then the antennae, It's a bit tricky because I don't have my small brush in here, but you're probably going to use a small brush for the antennas, so it will look better, but it gives you the idea how it will look. And then this part belongs to the behind, what's that called? The wing, which is the behind wing, and this one is the front wing. So it's a sideways butterfly this way.
Okay, yeah, I can see it. That's fab. Absolutely love it.
So I think it's dried enough, so I can show you how to put the middle things inside. Just this off. I'm still loading up my brush again with the same color, with the blue and the purple. And then I'm placing every petal, we're going to be in between the other ones. And then you just wriggle it again like this. If you have a dry, fully dry drawing, then it will look better exactly, but for the purpose of this video, I'm just quickly showing you. If it's not showing up well enough, you can go over it again. And there. I need to load it one more time. All of these techniques really is just have to practice, practice, practice. If you're really into art and craft and stuff, then you need to practice every day and then you become a master of it. I'm not sure if it's seen above well, but we
Oh.
have two layers now. Now, normally, where is my camera? Normally, we don't have gaps between the petals. I just leave the gap there for the purpose of this presentation so you could see how one petal look like. But normally we would put the petals next to each other or even overlaying each other. But that's something I'm going to teach in a VIP group. I just wanted to teach here the main techniques, the double dip, triple dip, and the one stroke techniques. So, let me turn this back around. All right. So, I hope you had some good value of this. And I do looking forward to see your pictures down below. I see people joining now, so hopefully they don't mind watching back all over again because we are just finishing up now. So if you joined now, you just go back and watch it from the beginning. And thank you, Nico, for being here with us. Did you paint your door or you've been just watching
I've just been watching you. I have, yeah.
me? Okay. Never mind that. Let's see how will it turn out if you practice at home. Let me
Yeah.
know. Show me the pictures below, and I can't wait to see everybody's creation. And I hope you enjoyed this. And thank you very much for being here with us. And see you.
Thank you. Bye.